Hi guys, in this tutorial I want to talk about scrolling screens and frames. Well, technically speaking, a screen is a frame, so it's kind of the same. It's kind of, but it's not exactly the same, and that can be a bit confusing. There is a difference between a frame that is the main container that holds our screen, like the ones I've created here. One is a desktop screen, one is a mobile screen, just like kind of like in a UX design. It really doesn't matter what is the content on these screens. But again, desktop screen and a mobile screen, they both have, they are both longer than the viewport. When I say viewport, it's, let's say, all the screen area, the screen which is actually, which makes the content visible. This is the viewport. In a mobile, your mobile screen, your mobile device actually is the viewport that you are looking at your screen from. Okay, so if I will go into prototype, or I am already in prototype, you will see that when I'm clicking on this, or actually selecting the mobile screen, you will see that the overflow scrolling is no scrolling. Okay, this I will use when I want to define a scrollable area inside this main container which holds the screen. I mean, don't be confused. Okay, this is the entire screen, that's the main frame that holds the screen. Here as well, if I want to define a scrollable area, meaning let's say a frame like that, of course I will show it, that will be scrollable, this is when I'm using the overflow scrolling. That could be a bit confusing. So you will see here, which I did hit the play already. So overflow scrolling, there is no scrolling, but you will see that I do have a scroll on this screen. Okay, these two are in a fixed position. The navigation bar, the bottom navigation bar, and the top area are just, if you see here, are at fixed position when scrolling. By the way, I do have a whole tutorial on fixed elements, sticky elements. So if you're not so familiar with it, you can definitely go ahead and see it. I will be more than happy. I will place the link already in the description. I mean, you will have the link to in the description of this tutorial. Okay, so again, going to the desktop, I will release it from the mobile screen. I will hit the play. Nothing happens. I will hit the play again. What's going on? Oh, let me see. None. Okay, let me close it and hit the play again. It's quite stubborn sometimes. Yeah. Okay. So, fit width. And you see that in this screen as well, I have a scrollable area. Until the footer area. So I do have a scroll on this screen, and this screen also is defined as no scrolling. But again, this is the main frame that is holding our screen. Okay, so we don't have to define a scrollable behavior on the entire screen, because if it's bigger than the viewport, it will have a scroll. Okay, the viewport again is the window that you are looking at the screen from. If I'll go back here, by the way, let me put it back on a mobile device, and I will make this frame, by the way, wider, like that. So you will see that now, let me hit the play again. Okay, so you will see now that I have a scroll to kind of like horizontal and vertical all together. So I also have the scroll to the left, sorry, to the right. Okay, I can scroll. It's kind of like very messy because now it scrolls like everywhere. but in general, if I'll, let's say, put it 812, let us make it shorter. And now you will see that, you see, I can scroll to the side and that's it. Okay, so as long as the main frame which holds the screen is bigger than the viewport, this is the viewport, we're gonna have a scroll. Now let's see how we are defining a scrollable area inside the entire screen. Okay, let's make it 375. Okay, now let's say that this frame which holds this long list, this is an auto layout, that's okay. I will make it like that. Okay, now this is the frame that holds this entire list, and clip content will actually hide the content which is outside. By the way, it doesn't matter if it's an auto layout or not, I will remove the auto layout, it really doesn't matter for the scrolling thing. So this frame now is just a short area, okay, inside the screen actually, and I want to define a scrollable area only by this frame. Okay, so what I am doing now is going into prototype, overflow scrolling. Now I will define vertical scrolling. So you will see now that I have a scroll inside this area. Okay, this is where I am defining it. Of course, it looks a bit weird. As a UX, as a user experience in general, I would strongly suggest not to make a vertical scrollable area inside a screen which is already vertically scrollable. It's gonna be a terrible user experience. I mean, I personally really hate that, but I'm just showing it technically how it's possible to do. Okay, another thing that I can do here, and of course that if I had a longer frame, let me make my frame longer, and we can have a few of these areas. The entire screen, which is not showing it, let's press play again. It's not really refreshing correctly. Okay, so the entire screen is scrollable, as you see, because we made the screen longer, and also each area to itself is scrollable, which is quite a weird experience, but in general, you can actually do that. Okay, so that's technically how it's done. Now, if we want to define a horizontal scroll, so we can do that. This is very simple. Okay, this is as long as your frame is going to be as long as your content in it is going to be. Okay, now here we have, let's see here, so this is the entire list which sits actually in this frame. Okay, and let's do a horizontal scroll is basically the same logic or the same way to do it. Let's say that I want to have something like, sorry, not that, let me just put it here, and let's say that I want to have a bunch of scrollable avatars here. Okay, so I'm gonna do something like that. And let me just select them all together. Let's make something like that, because we always want to give the user a scroll hint that he understands that the area is scrollable. Okay, and let's leave it just the color one. It doesn't really matter. We can easily put images inside it, but there's no way. I mean, there's no point to do it right now. It doesn't really matter. And let me just put them all in a frame, because as we said, a frame, and that is one of the things actually that is making the big difference between a frame and a group, which in Figma actually I never ever almost use a group, except for really a few cases of holding, let's say, some vector icons or something like that sometimes, but usually I will put them all in a frame, because a frame has a responsive behavior and a scrollable behavior. So let's continue. So this frame actually now holds all these circles, and which could, they can be images, avatars, it doesn't really matter. We're going into prototype mode, and now I'm gonna give it a horizontal scrolling behavior. Now notice the fact, by the way, you don't see whatever is going on here because the frame is in clip content mode. When I will uncheck this, you will see also the content which is outside of the border of this frame. Okay, now this frame is defined as horizontal scrolling. Notice this one, this alert or information icon, which tells you for scrolling to work on this frame, the content needs to be bigger than the frame. Okay, that means that if the content is the same width or height of the frame, you're not going to have any scrolling. Logically, makes sense. Okay, so we will make this frame smaller. Notice as I started to make it smaller, this alert went off, and I will put it in the width of the screen. That's okay. Now, I can define it also like that. It depends where I want to have the draggable area, which in it I will make the scrolling. And you will see that it doesn't refresh. We will play it again. Okay, so I can scroll freely this area. Okay. Now notice that when I scroll, I also see when it scrolls outside the border of this frame. We can see the content, meaning like here, okay? Because this frame doesn't have the clip content checked. If I will check the clip content, so now we can have a limited scrollable area, not the entire width of the screen, and we can make it like that. Of course, I can make it even smaller if I want something like that. So we can have a scrollable area which sits like that and have something to scroll inside it. And the area, we can limit the area as much as we want. Of course, if I will uncheck the clip content, now when I will scroll it, let me refresh that. That's pretty annoying. It doesn't refresh. Okay, I'm gonna hit the play again. I don't know why it does that. But anyway, now when I will scroll, you will see that actually the frame sits here, but I can see all the elements that are scrolling outside of it because it doesn't have the clip content clicked. Okay, so, or checked, more right to say. Okay, so again, so just to make it more simple, up until now, and there's another scroll I want to show, which actually I kind of showed it already, but I will show it more explainable. We can take a frame, and let's say that I will want to have a map. You know what? A map is good. Let's, you know what? One second. So to save time, I brought a screenshot of just a screenshot from Google Maps just to show the horizontal and vertical scrolling inside a frame, which is pretty easy. we're having this frame. I can take this map and just drag it inside it. Wait, let me see what's the name of this frame. Let's call it map. And I will just put this inside by dragging this image into the frame, which is called map. So now I have the map inside this frame, which has the clip content checked on it. If I will uncheck it, I will see it like that. And if I will check it again, so I see it like that. And here, actually, oh, we did refresh, by the way. Hallelujah. Okay, without having to press the play again. And now, oh, I didn't define any scrolling behavior on this frame, so I will do it right now. So now, as a default, when you draw a frame inside a screen, it has no scroll, actually any frame, even if I draw one here. So it has a no scrolling behavior. And now we can select horizontal and vertical scrolling. So when I do that, you will see that now I can do like that. I mean, I can move the map inside freely, vertically and horizontal directions. Okay, so this is horizontal and vertical scrolling. So we did the horizontal, we did the vertical, we did the horizontal and vertical, and we explained that a screen, meaning a frame, the main container which holds the screen, okay, all that, we don't have to define a scrolling overflow, I mean overflow scrolling, we don't have to define that, and the minute it will be bigger than our viewport, meaning the screen that we are looking on it from, it will have a natural scroll, and we don't have to define that. Okay, so I hope now that the whole scrolling thing in Figma is much more understandable. If you do have more questions, feel free to write to me in the comments area. Of course, I will be more than happy to help and answer questions and do even another tutorial if needed. So, thank you so much for seeing this tutorial. I would be happy for your like if you did like this tutorial. More than happy if you subscribe to my channel. And any tutorials you would like to have, you can just write to me. Thank you so much. Have a great Figma learning, and see you in the next tutorial. Bye for now.